Hi students, welcome to our second program on using strings. In this particular program, I am going to show you three or four of the most commonly used string functions. The first one is going to be string length, the second one is going to be copying one string to other, third is going to be string concat, and let's see how we go ahead with these particular string problems. So I have defined three array of characters as Arjun, Simba and Name. Now what I can do is I can ask the user, okay, or I can, let's first try to print the length of the string one. Printf length of, sorry, name one is equal to %d/n. So what I can do is I'm going to use a function called strlen, and I'm going to pass name1 to it. So this particular function is going to find the length of name1. So the length of name1 is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. The null is not counted. Okay. So just be sure Arjun is going to print the length as 5 characters. Then next what I can do is I can try to copy one string to the other. In order for me to use the string functions, it is imperative that I use this particular header file called as string.h, because string.h has the prototypes of string length, string copy and string concatenate and other commonly used string functions. Now suppose I want to copy a string, so I can use the word function strcpy and say I want to copy into name3 whatever is in name2. So what is going to happen here is Simba, which is in name 2, is going to get written into name 3. Now let's prove that. So what we can do is, in order to prove that, let's type that, and later on when I'm going to run the program, I'm going to show how the output is going to look. Okay. Content of name 2 is equal to, sorry, this should be name 2, is equal to %s after copying, okay, after strcpy will write. So you will understand that it was after the string copy function. So here you will just have to write %s, okay, sorry, the %s is already there, you will just have to write name 3. So here what is going to happen here is name 2 is going to be copied, that is Simba is going to be copied from name 2 onto name 3. So name 3 and name 2 both are going to be the same. Now if you try to print name 3, you are going to get an output which is called as Simba. Now what you can do here is, let us do one more function. Let us try to concatenate. That means you can, at the end of name 3, which happens to be Simba now, we can add Arjun at the end of it. So concatenation is trying to append one string to the other. So name 3. And what I can do is, instead of using name 1, let me try something else. Okay, so I'm just taking a string here and I'm appending it to string concat. So string concat is going to read Simba space Rajan. So what I can do is, I can say printf, I can say name 3 after, sorry, name 3 after strcat, after strcat is equal to %s backslash n, and then I can say name 3. Now there is one more option. What we can do is, we can also try to compare two strings. Okay, we can try to compare whether two of the strings are same. Like for example, we can compare whether Arjun is equal to, say, name 2, which happens to be Simba. If it is true, it will return some value. If it is false, it will not. strcmp, and I'm going to say is name 1 comma name 2. If they are equal, then string compare is going to return a value 0. Otherwise it's going to return a different number, which is generally the difference of their ASCII values. Both strings are equal. Okay, else printf both strings are diffrent. So first let's try to take this, let's see if it compiles, and then we shall take it from there. Because you just typed it, there could usually be typing errors. You never guaranteed that your typing is going to be perfect. So let's copy this particular fellow here. All right. So once I copy, I'll play around and I'll explain to you a little more things. Okay. So the first warning it's giving me is, it's trying to say that string length is returning an unsigned long. That is, it's returning an unsigned long int, but I'm using percentage D. So what I'll do is I'll stop this. I won't execute this piece of code. I will typecast the return value of string length to int. So what will happen is, since it's a small value, length of a string, it will be converted into int, and percentage D will perfectly work with it now. So let's first try to run this program and then go ahead with the explanation. All right. So if you look at this particular problem here, all right. So if you look at this particular problem here, Arjun happens to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what is the length of the string name 1? It also happens to be 5. Now what I have done is, I have copied name 2 into name 3. Okay. Actually, it should, I've done a typo here. It should be name 3. This should be name 3. I'll change it. Name 2 into name 3. So you can rightly see I'm printing name 3 here. So when I print name 3, what is printing? It is printing Simba, as I'm expecting it. Then what I am doing is, to Simba, I'm adding the name Rajan using this strcat or string concatenate. So what is happening is, after Simba, there is a space and Rajan. That is what happens in name 3. And lastly, I'm comparing two strings and it is showing differences. That means both are different. Let me try to do a few corrections and let me try to show you. This should be name 3, because I'll remove this so that it doesn't confuse you. So I'll just write strcpy so that you know after string copy you're getting this value of name. So in string compare, I'm comparing name 1. Name 1 happens to be Arjun. Name 2 happens to be Simba. Both are different, so obviously it is giving a different output. Now what we can do here is, we can just put a little spaces so it's a little more clearer, and we can also, let me run it once again and try to show this string compare. So if you see here in this last one, I'm comparing Arjun with Simba. It is very clear both the strings are different and it's clearly showing it. Now what I can do here is, I can play around a little bit. I can change name 2 to the same name. Okay, I can make this also as Arjun. Now if what I've done, or if string compare is working perfectly, okay, it should show that both are equal. Okay, now it is perfectly showing both are equal. A word with string compare. What happens with string compare is, string compare, when it compares any two strings, it is case sensitive. If I make this Arjun as a small a, alright, now you will see it will say that these two things are different. Both the strings are different. So here you can see the message. So the comparison is case sensitive. So I hope you have understood the simple program where I have shown you how to take the length of a string, how to copy one string to the other, how to append or concatenate, as they call in common C language, one string to the other, how to compare two strings to other.